Hey Matterporters, I'm Amir, and in this video, I'll go over how to mark features in the Capture app. Markings are used to provide information to the Capture app and the processing engine about mirrors and windows, as well as parts of the 3D geometry or the dollhouse you don't want to have included in your final model. Let's first talk about the mirror markings. It's really important to tell the Capture app where mirrors are located by using a mirror marking. If you don't do this, the software won't know that what's being reflected in the mirror isn't an extra room behind the mirror itself. Then when you get to scan what's actually behind the mirror, the software will get confused and may not align as a result. Marking the mirror tells the software to ignore anything it thinks might be behind that mirror. Place a mirror marking as soon as you can see the mirror in the minimap, and be sure the arrow is pointing into the room or area where the mirror is located. You should mark windows to fill in the window pane with 3D geometry in the dollhouse view. If you forget to mark a window, it will appear as a hole in the model, but you can always mark it later and re-upload if that's the case. Trim markings are intended for outdoor scans, such as on a patio or walkway. They're also very helpful if you only scan part of a room. The trim marking removes extra 3D data, also called spray, so that the dollhouse and floor plan views look clean. For most normal walls, trim markings are not necessary. To place a marking, first navigate and zoom into the appropriate spot on the minimap. Tap the Mark Features button and then choose the marking you'd like to add. Tap and drag on the minimap to set the beginning and end points of the marking. Once the marking is set, you can tap and drag the end points to tweak the line, or drag the center to move the line altogether.